travel with me. Hey fellow humans, Mina here. Welcome back to another Drive and Talk, and it's Pride Month, so we're going to be talking about the gay books, because I can, and I'd like to do another one of those videos of mine, hi Soren, where I stand in front of the bookshelf and show off all the best reads of all the best gay books that I've read for Pride this year, and I may or may not do that. We'll find out next week if that's what happens, but for now, I did read this book, this Pride, and I just really need to share it because it is everything I need it right now in my life. And this book is called The Perfect Guy Doesn't Exist by Sophie Gonzalez, and for some reason the title made me think, you know, it was about like gay guys, but it's actually not, the sapphic novel. But yeah, this is a spoiler free review of a very light read, but yeah, this was the book I really needed to read right now. Not gonna lie, it was a bit too cheesy at the start, but as I read, the message and some of the prose spoke to me. I know it's not the most profound book out there, it's very YA, but I'm going through some personal things in my life, and there were some things written in this book that I needed to hear, and it really helped me, so props for helping my mental health. There's a reason I read all of this author's books. They always find a way to help me with whatever is going on in my life. I know this won't apply to everyone, so disregard this part of the review if you feel like it. I know that I loved what I read, and it has helped me. Speaking of what I read, the show Ivy is obsessed with sounds lame as hell, but I do love her passion for it. I love that she has her BFF Henry to geek out to, and her other friend to enemy to more, Mac, for other needs. As mentioned a bit above the start of this book, though still pretty good overall, was a bit too cheesy, and I wasn't gonna give it 5 stars because of it. Even though I really enjoyed it, I thought maybe this book wasn't for me, but the more I read, the more I got into it, and the less I found it to be cheesy. I mean, it still was, but it was enjoyable cheese, you know? Though reading Ivy's fanfic passages, those were the cringiest, not gonna lie. Gonzalez managed to pour Ivy's personality into those, as they didn't have Gonzalez's voice at all, and were actually kind of terrible, not gonna lie. I'm not sure how Ivy and her fans... Ivy has any fans reading her fanfics, but hey, to each their own. I know the fanfic writing part isn't supposed to be a masterpiece, and it was there for the plot to happen, but that didn't mean they had to be as cringe as they were to read. All in all, I am so happy to read this book. It was the perfect read at the perfect time. It's a really nice and light and fluffy read without any trigger warnings, because there are none, and we love a good bi rep. Heck, we have lots of LGBTQ+ reps, and I'm always here for that. Also, the cover is gorgeous, and I just so happen to have a signed copy because I pre-ordered this book, and I got special pre-order bonuses, so love that. But yeah, and the cover is gorgeous, if I haven't already said that. And if you want a cheesy, fluffy, feel-good YA read, I highly recommend this book. So yeah, how about you guys, my fellow humans? Are you into YA romance books, or adult ones, or you fine with either? Let me know in the comments down below, and let me know if you've read this book or any other of Sophie Gonzalez's work. I'd love to hear from you. So yeah, hope your pride is going well, whether you're part of the letter acronym or an ally. I hope you're staying safe and all that fun jazz, and happy reading or writing or otherwise. So yeah. Anywho, that's all I get to say for now. If you want to keep hearing more about stuff, be sure to follow me on all your favorite socials. Links below. Stay safe and take care. Bye!